What if I told you that everything you knew about 1920s German cinematic adaptations was wrong? What if I told you that Disney, aside from making a lot of cool projects over the years, built its empire on a lie? What if I told you that animation history has been wrongly written by the victors? Ladies and gentlemen, from my last ever project in college and life, I present to you Lonnie Reininger, Portrait of a Lady Who Makes Fire. Okay, I'm going to do an overview, but really I'm going to be focusing on the adventures of Prince Ahmed. Hailing from 19th century Berlin, Charlotte, or Lottie for those of us cool enough to realize that it's an elaborate nickname, was interested in films from a young age, inspired by people like Georges Méliès. Thus started her interest in paper cutting silhouette work, aka Wayang puppetry. That's right, this cross-cultural adventure starts not in Germany, not even in the Middle East, but in the Far East, Indonesia, Java. Wayang tells stories, we're talking folk tales, by using shadow puppetry. So Reininger was inspired by that. She didn't copy it, just got some heavy inspiration. In fact, she took what already existed in many faraway cultures for hundreds of years and
now flip it and reverse it. It's your primitive plan yet.
Improved it. The point is, everything is a copy of a copy of a copy of a copy of a copy, all right? You see, the challenge that she faced is the motion pictures effect, aka for their 1926 animated feature, based on a collection of folktales from the Islamic Golden Age called 1001 Nights, she and her cohorts remarkably and painstakingly created about 96,000 frames over the course of 3 years. All right, let's do some quick maths, okay? 96,000 divided by 24 frames per second, that's 4,000. Okay, carry the one, 4,000 divided by 60, that's about 67 minutes. So yeah, it basically checks out. Many stop-motion films then and today didn't even bother with that 24 FPS stuff, instead going for 14. Impressive work, Reininger. She introduced a new depth to the field of animation, both literally and figuratively. In a literal sense, she created something remarkable. It's called the Tricktisch, literally meaning trick table in German.
The trick table. If you don't have such a thing at home, you take your best dining table, cut a hole into it, put a glass plate over it, and over the glass plate some transparent paper, and then you put some light on from underneath. And then you switch the other light in the room out, then you see with joy that your figure now is a real silhouette.
She developed this with her husband, Carl Koch. By the way, he is not probably related to those Koch brothers. By the way, there's nothing weird about creatively collaborating with your life partner. They were actually a dedicated artistic and political duo, involved with left-wing politics, fleeing Hitler, being forced to work with him. Anyways, the point is, I digress. The Tricktisch setup was an early form of the multiplane camera, in which a camera is set up above several layers of drawings to add multiple dimensions of detail to the image. Now, this is no easy setups. You had to have the lights, the camera, the figures, the whole backlit shindig, using glass panels. And in a way, those glass panels represented the glass ceiling that she, Lonnie Reininger, a woman, would break through. Collecting and displaying Arabian folk stories, she couldn't even get distribution for the film until almost a year later, when famed Frenchie Jean Renoir, the bad boy of early cinema, shouted her out. In fact, he once said to her, "You have fairy hands." And back then, he meant it in a good way. But on a deeper level, what kind of depth was there? Well, let's take a deeper dive. She, in fact, as aforementioned, was a woman, and therefore a pioneer, and therefore a forgotten pioneer. The claim to fame for the adventures of Prince Ahmed is that it is the oldest surviving animated feature film. Extra emphasis put on surviving, because many argue that she was actually predated by Argentinian animator Quirino Cristiani, who made El Apostol in 1917. However, according to former Canadian associate professor Mark Langer of Carleton University fame, the jury is still out on this one. Rather than quibbling between Argentinian or German auteurs, what we should woke ourselves towards is the fact that Lottie basically adapted the multiplanar technique and Disney thieved it. I mean, just look at Walt Disney here talking about this stuff like he invented the darn thing.
It also came out of our school of self-improvement here at the studio. It is a blueprint of a piece of equipment designed to make cartoons more realistic.
The Adventures of Prince Ahmed was also super edgy, by which, of course, I mean a member of the avant-garde. Helping her with the innovative techniques, aside from Coke, was Bertold Bartosz. She also ran in circles with Fritz Lang and Bertolt Brecht, and worked on this one with Oscar Fischinger and Walter Ruttmann. Now, I'm going to stop you on that last one there, because Ruttmann was a real experimental innovator. I'm talking Opus 1, I'm talking Berlin Symphony. In other words, the real deal. Animation and avant-garde, or experimental cinema, often went hand in hand in the early days, both in content and form. This was far from the days of the Lady and the Tramp live remake Mo Money Mo Problems.
Every day could be an adventure.
As Reiniger herself said, no theater dared show it. Those remarkable color backdrops were there in the original. So in a way, it's the oldest colored animated feature film too, by a woman nonetheless. And for the music, they worked with German composer Wolfgang Zeller in the early days to standardize an orchestral score which included some imagined glockenspiel sound effects. But nowadays, everyone from Brooklyn hipsters to Spanish rockers to Scottish jazz cats to coming up with their own renditions. Pretty cool. What's that you say? How does this affect me today, Sean? Well, scissors and pieces of paper for animation. I wonder who that could be. The silhouettes have the effect of creating universality, showing no race or Nazi beauty standards like Walt Disney presents Snow White supremacy, but rather a person's essence, their spirit. Lottie Reiniger had an incredible and persistent spirit, and at the end of the day, as we're making our way through our 1001 movies you must watch before you die list, isn't that all we can ask for?
Kumbaya, my lord, kumbaya.
Kumbaya, my lord, kumbaya.
Hey, young Metro, I don't trust you, I'm gonna shoot you.
Straight.
Do you know? Be my best friend, 7-Eleven, bingo legend.